Trailing at 2 wins and 19 losses. We're coming to you from the Ucarachan Arena, and we promise you a good one. It's going to be a barn burner because both these teams desperately need a victory here to jumpstart their season. In just a bit, we're going to be showing you the team standings. There it is right now. You can see mired in the cellar in their conference is Niigata at 219. Shiga Lake Stars not doing that much better at 7 wins and 14 defeats. Actually, looking at their seasons last year, Shiga Lake Stars were in 13th place overall with a 23-36 card, while Niigata Albirex was in 17th with 16 victories and 38 defeats. And so they want to be able to come up with a much better showing here this season. They've revamped their squads. They've gotten a lot of new additions. But so far, it has really not panned out, especially for Niigata, who are on an 18-game losing streak. Obi Soko there on your screens, bannering the squad of the Shiga Lake Stars. They actually split their games last weekend to Yokohama. They had a victory last December 18. They won that game 76-62. But unfortunately, they lost in the very next day 98-85. So they're coming off a loss and wanted to get right back into the win column. There on your screens, you have the lineup of the Shiga Lake Stars. And then, followed that, you had Niigata Albirex. There's Novar Gadsden, hitting from the outside. This, as I mentioned, some of the action of the two games they played last weekend. Gadsden was a monster there. On the other side of the coin, Niigata Albirex. You see there on your screens. That's the action that they had against the Hiroshima Dragonflies. They were at home, and unfortunately, they lost both games. They lost on December 18, 88-76, and the very next day, December 19, losing 82-63. This is the matchup that we're going to be looking forward to. Novar Gadsden up against Roscoe Allen. You can see the numbers of both these imports. Impressive numbers. And both these teams would want to have their main men coming up with big performances here on Christmas Day. And let's meet the players now from both these squads. And what better way to spend your Christmas Day afternoon than with us here in the B-League. Anthony Sutai with the coverage. Glad you're joining us. It's Kiefer Ravenna and the Shiga Lake Stars hosting Kobe Paras and the Niigata Albirex.
ご起立ください。夏原様は 平和堂にオフィシャルパートナーとなっていただいた2010-11 シーズンには代表取締役社長として先頭を切ってサポートをしていただき、今シーズンメインオフィシャルパートナーとなっていただいた際は、日本一を目指すのであればこれまで以上に応援が必要と力強い言葉で後押しをいただきました。また株主としてもクラブ運営をご支援いただくなど、滋賀レイクスターズのこれまでの歩みに多大なお力添えを賜るとともに、発展の礎を築いていただきました。那須原様に謹んで追悼の意を表し、ここで黙祷を捧げたいと思います。黙祷。ご着席ください。
And there we just had a moment of silence. And now let the festivities begin here for Christmas Day as the Shiga Lake Stars face Niigata Albirex. Now calling out the starting five for Niigata Albirex. Number four, Jeff Ayers, who won a championship with the San Antonio Spurs in 2014. Kobe Paras from the Philippines. Number 14, Keigo Kimura. Number 15, Silitsi Nepawe from South Africa, one of their international imports. And number 17, Shun Watanuki. And now let's have the fanfare for the hometown Shiga Lake Stars. There we have the starters for the Shiga Lake Stars. A little bit of a change once again here in the starting lineup of Coach Luis Gil Torres. Today, he's starting out with Tepe Kashiwagura. We have Daichi Nomoto, number 23, Novar Gadson, number 33, Shotaro Hayashi, and number 54, Sean O'Mara. Sean O'Mara is actually the only player that has started in all of their games. There are a couple of games they've had Obi Soko. In fact, most of the games that we have covered here for the B-League coverage, they've had Obi Soko starting, but now they're going to have him coming off the bench. Tepe Kashiwagura has started a lot of their games. This is one of the few times that we're going to have Novar Gadson starting. A little bit of festivities first here before we actually begin the competition here this Christmas Day. Well, I guess for Coach Luis Gil Torres, They really need to be able to find out what they can possibly do. Not just get a win, but put the wins in succession for Niigata Albirex. They will shake up also once again in their starting lineup. And we're ready to get underway here. Our officials for this match, we have referee Okawara, referee Kubo, and referee Iwatsuki. Welcome back to the Ukarochan Arena. There's Obi Soko coming off the bench here today. Usually starts. Let's see if that gamble pays out for coach Luis Gil Torres as we go through the starters once again for Niigata Albirex, the away squad. Starting out with Ayers, Paras, Kimura, Nepawe, and Watanuki. For the home squad, they've got Kashiwagura, Nomoto, Gadsden, Hayashi, and O'Mara. And Merry Christmas, everybody. Once again, B-League action coming your way. First possession, Tushiga. They go out to Gadsden. They swing it over. Looks inside. O'Mara can't kiss it off the glass. A little bit too strong. One and done. Calling out the play. They go out to Jeff Ayers. Then to Nepawe. A lot of movement being shown. Paras from the outside. Banks that one in. The bank is open here for Kobe Paras. 3-0. Niigata. Quite sure he called that one, but as far as he's concerned, he's on the board, and so is his squad. Gadsden, double team there from Paras. Open three! No. All by his lonesome there was Shotaro Hayashi. Couldn't drain that triple. A lot of times, you saw even in the last possession, he was free. Seems like the boys in white are giving up the corners. Let's see if that continues. Of course, Hayashi needs to be able to make that shot. Paras will give it up to Ayers. We go inside to Nepawe. Good hands coming here from Sean O'Mara. And Nepawe doesn't like the call. O'Mara swiped down. Might have come off the knee here of Nepawe. He doesn't agree. But we're going the other way. Still a 3-0 lead by Niigata. Hayashi now out of the corner. They'll give it up. They go inside to Sean O'Mara. He's a monster inside. Three on the way. Nothing doing that time from Kashiwagura. They're getting their shots from that right side of the court, but they haven't hit any. Ayers, long two, misfires. Rebound, nonchalantly puts it up, and still a miss there from Watanuki. Here's Gadsden. He'd like to be able to attack. Talking about Shiga. Early in the shot clock. Inside to O'Mara. He's a little bit gun shy. They're going to get possession. Shot clock down to 7. Hayashi left open. And finally hits. 1 out of 3 from the field here from Hayashi. And we're tied at 3. Gadsden with a steal in the open court up against Ayers. We'll give it up. O'Mara inside. Basket and one opportunity. And Ayers doesn't like the call. But Sean O'Mara says, give me a 3-point play opportunity early here this Christmas afternoon. That's a poor pass. And a double black eye here for Jeff Ayers. That turnover began with him. He can't complain. His arm was all over the arm of Sean O'Mara. First personal foul on Ayers. Sean O'Mara trying to give Niigata a 3-point lead. Does so. Each team has led by 3 points early in this ballgame. They look for Paras now. Barrasco, the only basket here of Niigata off that bank three. Barras might lose it. Eventually does. Tries to come up with a block. Hayashi gets blocked. That started out with the defense of Kobe, but well, that turnover started there on that particular sequence. Kobe came back down, tried to stop the basket, and helping him out was Kimura. But the possession will stay here with Shiga. They've gotten two steals already. And we're only 3 minutes into the ballgame. Nice cut, Gadsden. Basket and one opportunity. And lead is back up. Is now up, rather, to five. Could we have another completed three-point play? Nice cut, and the foul is going to be called there on number three, Kotaro Oya. He actually just checked in, and he commits an early foul. Gadsden completes a three-point play, and now it's a six-point lead at 9-3. Two consecutive three-point plays by the imports of Shiga. Nice to see Coach Luis Gil Torres back on the sidelines. He was ill. There's another steal. 2-1 break. They look for the secondary break. They kick it out though. O'Mara will wait for the rest of the troops. Kashiwagura. Nice handoff inside. Just too deep there. O'Mara gives his squad an 11-point lead. Let's see if they try to go inside to Nepawe. They try to. Nepawe kicks it out. One and done. Here's Paras inside. Forces the action. Expected a call. None was given. And Shiga off and running once again. A foul is going to be called there on Oya. That's going to be his second. He hasn't even been on the floor for a minute and a half. Already picking up two quick fouls. Jeff Ayers, after that quick foul, was lifted. First entry here of Kimitake Sato. Surprisingly, still no Roscoe Allen here for the visiting team, which is quite surprising. He leads their team in most of the stats. Gadsden operates inside, puts it up, will miss. Nepawe clears the board, and he'll bring it up himself. Eventually, give it up. Here's Watanuki calling out the play. Paras has been lifted. He's the only scorer here, and still the only scorer for the boys in white. Shiga gonna run once again. Poor pass. Intercepted, and that's clearly a foul. Kashiwagura is going to pick up his first. One of the few turnovers. .523 remaining here in the first period. It's an 11-3 advantage enjoyed by hometown Shiga Lake Stars. They get it to Endo. He just checked in. He's one of their main local players. Nepawe there gets rejected. Novar Gadsden on the run. Foul's going to be called on the floor. Nepawe starting to show a little bit of frustration here. Personal foul, First personal foul going to be called there on Tomoki Hoshino. And now Niigata's going to be in the penalty. So free throws the rest of the 5 minutes here in the first period for Shiga. Let's see if they try to take advantage. Three-point on the way, hits! That's going to increase their lead. Nice basket there from the outside from Tepe. 14-3. That's clearly a foul there by Daichi Nomoto. Not quite sure why he had to do that. Jeff Ayer is going to check back in. Roscoe Allen is actually listed here today, but we have yet to see him fielded in by Coach Fujitaka Hiraoka, who you have on your screens. Not surprising that he lifted Jeff Ayers very quickly, and now suddenly his team's down by 11. So if Roscoe Allen is not ready to go, they might be in deep trouble. Talking about the boys in white, Niigata Albirex. Here's Gadsden once again. Gadsden's going to attack, and a foul is going to be called. That's two free throws for Novar. He knew exactly what he needed to do. He made contact there through Watanuki out of the area. That's going to be Watanuki's first personal. And two free throws coming up here to add to the tally of Novar Gadsden. He already has a three-point play completed. And more trouble here for Niigata, because now Obisoko is in. Obisoko is their leading scorer. A little bit of change of pace done here by Coach Luis. Yuto Nomi is going to check in for the first time. That's a nice look there at Silidzi Nepawe from South Africa. 32 years old, standing 6'10". Gadsden's not going to get the first. Still a comfortable 11-point lead here for the boys in blue. Make that a 12-point lead at 15-3. And the only points on the board, courtesy of Paras off that bank three. Ayers will hand it off. Four shot there from Endo. Nepawe finally powers his way through. He might have an easier time here now that Sean O'Mara sat down. Gadsden from the outside, a little bit too strong. Ayers with the board. He's got the lead down to five. Early seal. And a foul is going to be called on Gadsden. That's going to be his first. Not exactly sure you want to pick up your fouls in that particular manner. Here comes Sean O'Mara. That's a better matchup. That is the matchup that has given Silidzi Nepawa nightmares. He's here this afternoon. One and done once again. Well, not able to bring it in off that rebound there. And Coach Luis saying, hey, my guy got the ball and he got hit. Ball will stay here with the visiting squad. Niigata still down by five. That's a dangerous pass. And take your pick. Soko's going to bring it all the way through. And that's going to force a timeout here from Coach Fujitaka. Things are starting to fall apart for Niigata as they find themselves down by 12 at 17-5. 3 minutes, 35 seconds remaining here in the first period. Still no Roscoe Allen here for the visiting squad, which is quite surprising. He's done it all for the squad. Lead pass not going to work. Another steal, another turnover here. Just too many steals allowed and too many turnovers by the visiting squad. That's why they're down by 12. O'Mara from the outside, a little bit too strong that time. Kenigata trying to come closer. Ayers. They look inside. Nepawe overshoots. He's had real trouble there with Sean O'Mara. Tepe will attack. Kick it out. That's a nice block. Obisoko denied. Can they score on the other end? Zen Endo does. Endo is cat quick. He's been cut down to 10. Tepe bringing it down. No, his team's got control. Not wanting to rush things. Hands it off to Nomoto. Soko, will he challenge? He'll bring it out. Nomoto. That's nice ball movement. Tepe for three. No. Ayers tracks it down. Hands it off. Here comes Nigata. Trying to cut into that lead even more. Inside to Nepawe. Inside, outside, back inside. Nice bounce pass. Zen Endo hits. Cutting from the weak side. Surprised the defense. Zen Endo with back-to-back baskets. And he's on the line for a three-point play opportunity. Foul's going to be called on Nomoto. Nomoto says it's clean. But a foul will be charged to him. Zen Endo looking for his fifth point here today. Zen Endo hasn't played as much as he would like to, and so he's trying to make up for some borrowed time. And you can see he's fresh here. Before this contest, he's been averaging his 23 minutes on the floor with averages of 7 points, 1 rebound, 1 assist. He missed that free throw, though. O'Mara tries to hand it off. Kiefer Aveno's just checked in. Gives it up. O'Mara with a jumper. Not that time. Ayers another board. Ayers has done well. He's got 3 rebounds already. He has not scored yet for his squad, though. Nepawe sets that pick. Zen Endo for 3. Short. Ayers with the last touch. Good box out there from Obisoko. Zen. Very aggressive here. Well, the fans of Nigata just glad to have him back in action. Novar Gadsden's going to check back in. A minute 20 remaining here in the first canto. Rion Shibuta has checked in. He's manning the backcourt together with Kiefer. Ovi Soko gets away for 2. Soko now with 4 points. Shibuta, one of those point guards that will harass you from the backcourt. Another pass, trying to thread the needle, doesn't work. Gadsden, check that, that's Ovi Soko getting the shooter's bounce. And that lead is back up to 12 here. Almost another ill-advised pass. That's clearly a foul. That's a very bad foul. And Ozawa wondering why he was called. Watch this. He clipped the arm, pulled Nepawe backwards. That is probably the most obvious foul I've seen this entire season. And Ozawa still complaining. And I said it's a poor foul because it's free throws here. Just when Niigata seems to be struggling to get some points, you're going to send their South American import, South African import, check that, to the free throw line for two. Nepawe makes the first. Nepawe with pretty good averages of 11 points, 7 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 steal, and 1 block. He'll make both. So today he's got 4 points, 2 boards, and 2 dimes. Kiefer rushing down court. We'll try to go for the 2-for-1. Katzen for 3. He'll come up short. Now going for the last shot is Zen Endo and company. Down 10. They've only scored 11 points. They'd like to make it at least 13. And they come much closer here in the dying seconds of the first. Trying to go inside. Nepawe just couldn't control it. That was a great pass. Shun found Nepawe. A little bit of butterfingers that time. 1.9 seconds in this one. Before we call a close to the first period. Trying to fight Obi Soko. He can't control it as well. First 10 minutes in the books. And it's a 10-point lead enjoyed by Shiga. They're up 21-11. Merry Christmas and welcome to the Ukarochan Arena, the home of the Shiga Lake Stars, as Kiefer Ravenna hosts Kobe Paras and Niigata Alberex here this Christmas Day. Second period, just about ready to begin. Coach Luis Gil Torres stressed to his team, he wanted them to start off strongly. That's exactly what has happened. They're up by 10. Zendo with the curl, doesn't get it. Long three for Ayers. One and done. Kiefer now. Using that Soko pick. Kiefer. His pass telegraphed. They're going to get it back. Kiefer forces the issue and he will be called for a charge. Nice position there from Shun Watanuki. Yeah, it is in the replay. First personal foul going to be called on Kiefer. Chance of defense. That is clearly a backing violation. Not too much pressure being put on. Well, correction, there was a lot of pressure there put on by Kiefer, which forced that turnover. Turnover numbers here for Niigata, already 9 and just 1 for Shiga. Gadsden, off the glass, count it, basket and 1. Novar Gadsden, sudden burst of speed there. Suddenly took it to the basket and the foul might be on Nepawe. That's going to be Nepawe's first. Still no Roscoe Allen. He's on the bench. You can see him there at the end of the bench. And he's dressed. Still no report coming out of their camp. So far it's a coach's decision. No injury reported. Zen Endo. That was a good line, but he missed everything. Gadsden will give it up. Kiefer to Soko. Three-man game there by the imports. Now inside to Soko. Soko against Ayers. Quick movement. Rion will miss. Ayers with another rebound. Rion now. Trying to stay in front of Watanuki. Nepawe gets rejected. It falls in the hands of Kiefer. They don't have numbers, but Kiefer's going to force the issue. Rion says, let's set things up. Got a lot of time on the shot clock. Nice basket there from Rion Shibuta. He desperately wanted that basket after missing an open shot a while ago. Makes up for that. And the lead is up to 15 at 26-11. This is the biggest lead now for either squad. Niigata led at 3-0, and they've been trailing ever since. Foul's going to be called there on Shibuta. Get it inside. Ayers will give it up. Nepawe. He's got the advantage there. There is no way Ovi Soko can stay with him. Nepawe is just too strong inside. Let's see if there are any adjustments going to be made by Shiga. Well, the best adjustment they can make is send in Sean O'Mara. Three on the way, not going to work. Ayers, another rebound. Watanuki controlling, gives it up to Ayers. Ayers inside. And a foul will be called here on Ovi Soko. That'll be the first on Ovi. And as expected, Sean O'Mara will check in. He has been able to make life miserable for Nepawe. Let's see if that continues. If it's Gadsden or Soko, Nepawe just overpowers them. This is a better matchup, Shiga-wise. Trying to get inside, throws it up with the left, doesn't work. Sean O'Mara gives it up to Rion. Shibuta will wait for the rest of the troops. They go inside. O'Mara, will he challenge? He does. A little bit of a bump there, but the referees let it go. But O'Mara was going to pick up another 2 points. And the lead is back up to 15. A little bit too high there from Zen Endo. Shibuta We wait for O'Mara. Use that screen. And then give it out. Gadsden for three. In and out. Good rotation being done here by Coach Luis Gil Torres. Most of his players are fresh. Here's Ayers up against O'Mara. With that switch, they might want to go inside to Nepawe, but it's a 3-second violation going to be called on Silidzi. His eyes were wide open because he saw that it was Novar Gadsden guarding him. Rion Chibuta did very well. And back in is Tepe Kashibagura. Ikeda will check in for the boys in white. Yuichi Ikeda, standing 6'3". He's a veteran at 33 years old. Checking back in is Hayashi. He hit a three at the corner a while ago. That was in the first period. 4 minutes gone in the second period. Depe feels he got hit. Sean O'Mara hits the deck. Ayers is going to pick up the loose ball. It's a 4-on-3 break. They try to go inside. That might be number two on Novar Gadsden. Nice seal by Jeff Ayers. Clearly a foul there on Gadsden. That's going to be number two. Let's see if Soko comes in. Soko will come in. So we can see Luis Gil Torres really making sure that he's got the right personnel. Especially given the situation, because already with two personal fouls now is Gadsden. So Soko in with just one. Traveling is going to be called there on Jeff Ayers, and he knew it. The moment he heard the whistle, it's going to be another turnover here for Niigata as he tried to challenge Kiefer Abena there. 11 turnovers already. And that's why Niigata finds themselves down and down big. They're down 15. Three for Kiefer. Short. Good transition defense though by the home team. Let's see, they try to go inside. They should. They've got Nepawe there. They just can't seem to get the right angle for the pass. Finally they get it inside. Nepawe though, up against O'Mara. He'll come up short. O'Mara with the pass. Easy layup there for Kiefer Avena. That's going to lead to this technical timeout. O'Mara there with good defense, leading to an easy transition bucket for Kiefer Avena. Good afternoon and welcome back to the Ukarochan Arena, the home of the Shiga Lake Stars. As Kiefer Ravenna hosts Nikata Alberex and Kobe Paras. Kobe Paras surprisingly has not yet been fielded in. He started out this ball game, hit a three. And we have not yet seen him. Roscoe Allen also missing in action for the boys in white here this afternoon. That's really done them in. They're down by 17. Nice basket. That's going to beat the shot clock. And coach Luis Gil Torres applauds the defense despite the fact that his squad was able to give up 2 points. Basket there from Nomi. Kiefer to Ovi. Will get it back. Soko from 15 feet. That's going to rim out. Ayers is down. They could stop the action. And eventually they will. Let's check in now on Jeff Ayers. Looks like he got a, initially looked like he got hit in the gut. And he quickly went down. Let's see if we can get that from another angle. He seems okay. Just got the wind knocked out of him, but again, if you're not going to play Roscoe Allen, who's averaging 32 minutes with 19 points, 8 rebounds, 4 assists, and 1 steal, there he is helping out Jeff Ayers. You've got to field in Kobe Paras. Not quite sure what the reason is, because Roscoe Allen looks like he's good. And there's Kobe Paras right beside him. Well, we know Kobe Paras can play. He started out in this ballgame. There's Roscoe Allen. Not quite sure if he's ailing. He has not yet been used here this afternoon. But Kobe Paras was utilized earlier. But he continues to stay on the bench. Jump ball. Where does the possession arrow point to? We're going the other way. 15-point lead enjoyed here by Shiga. After trailing earlier 3-0, they've taken control, and so far they've not looked back. Under 4 minutes to play here. First half action. A lot of basketball still to be played in the second half, but I'm wondering what has happened to Kobe Paras. We'll see if we can get a report about Roscoe Allen as well. But so far, Shiga and their fans are loving every minute of this Christmas Day game. Why not? Their squad is up. Kiefer to the wing. A little bit too strong on that three. O'Mara was in the mix, but Nepa was going to clear. And here comes Watanuki. Inside. Tsilidze gets his two. Finally gets away there from Sean O'Mara. And that's going to be the first personal foul on Sean. Nice up and under move. One of the few times Nepawe has been able to extricate himself from that leech-like defense. Now on the line for this free throw. Nepawe is going to miss that free throw, but he's got 8 points to go with 5 rebounds and 2 assists here so far. Approaching the 3 minute mark. Nice tip, not gonna work still. 2 opportunities missed there by Ovi Soko. They're gonna set things up as they wait for Jeff Ayers. About ready to check in. Active hands from Sean O'Mara. And here they come, 3-on-1 break. And it turns out to be a good decision. It seems like Ovi Soko could have given it up. Watch it here. Made contact. He actually had Nomoto there for an easy layup. Right now, they say it's going to work because 3 points in the offing if he makes his free throw. Look at the team foul situations. Shiga is in the penalty. Niigata just with two. It is back up to 15. It once stood at 17. Ayers officially checks back in. Bonus free throw. A little bit too strong. Kobe Parra still on the bench. And that was good defense. That's what Nomoto can give you. That's a good call. Just too many turnovers here. Look at the turnover story. 3 for Shiga, 13 for Niigata. And Shiga's taken well advantage. Tepe is going to misfire. That might be a foul on Nepawe. It is. That's going to be the second on Tsilidzi. Well, checking that. That might be a foul on Ikeda. It is on Ikeda. So just one foul in Nepawe. Nomoto kicks it out. Hayashi. Sean O'Mara just nonchalantly took a shot. He'll miss though. Watanuki. Steam down by 15. Tsilidzi. Too far out. Might want to try to go inside off that switch because Nepawe is being guarded by Ovi Soko. Taking baking move, not going to work. Jeff Ayers with the offensive rebound. 3 on the way, yes! Extra possession helps out. And knocking down that 3 was Yuto Nomi. And now, seems like a timeout is going to be called here by Coach Luis Gil Torres. Not liking the fact that his team yielding, and there it is. You see, the moment that shot went up, even before it went in, Coach Torres was already asking for a timeout. Under 2 minutes to be played here in the first half. Well played two quarters so far here by Shiga. But hanging around are the boys in white. Niigata Alberex still to use Roscoe Allen and sparingly using Obi Parras, as you can see him there. With a look of dismay as he saw Obi Soko get that dunk. Soko now with 10 points. Lead is back up to 14. Almost a held ball. That was very close to a jump ball. Also very close to 5 seconds. Ayers. Ayers forces it up. Will miss. Nepau is there. And he cleans it up. 10 points also now for Nepawe, equaling the output of Ovisoko. Remember, today Ovisoko coming off the bench. O'Mara inside. And now a timeout is going to be called here by Coach Fujitaka. His team down by 14. Let's see what he does with his substitution patterns when we come back. And now chance of defense here for the final minute of action before we take a halftime break. And the fans here at Ukarachan Arena, happy. Their team is up by 14. They've led after being down early at 3-0. Nice seal by Nepawe. They send the double. And the defense is going to work here. Another 3-second violation going to be called on Silidzi. Let's see if Coach Hideoka decides to come up with some changes come the next two periods. He likes the effort of his squad, though. Well, despite the fact that they've been only playing with two imports, Soko will come up with a turnover. Soko helped up there by Hayashi, as he apologizes to the fans. Difference of 1.4 seconds from the game clock and the shot clock. Ayers will hand it off. Set a little bit of a pick. Help his point guard get through. And a foul is going to be called there, and Jeff Ayers doesn't like it. Ozawa's going to pick up his second personal. Well, Ozawa's a bruiser. He's there to make life difficult here for Ayers. And there you can see, he just held on to Jeff. That's his second foul here today, and it's the second really poor one. Twice he's come in the latter part of the periods, and he's come up with horrendous fouls. Ayers should stop complaining. Just head on over to the free throw line and make the shots. And be thankful. Jeff Ayers has yet to score. He's got 8 rebounds. But Jeff Ayers will pick up a technical foul there. He wasn't happy with the way he was manhandled by Ozawa. He's got to realize Ozawa's in there to make sure he gets under the skin of the imports. Ozawa's going to miss. And now Ayers will take his two shots. Expect Ozawa to be right in the grill of Jeff Ayers once again. when action begins. That's a very poor foul, though. You can see that Niigata has been struggling to score. They only scored 11 points in the first period. Now, so far, only scored 11 points in the second. And now you're going to give two easy shots from the 15-foot line to a very good free-throw shooter in Jeff Ayers, who has yet to score, and now he just might see the ball go through the hoop. That just might spark something from Jeff. And Nepawe continues to talk to him, calming him down. And now, after everything has been said and done, he can take these two free throws. And it could be a four-point play. No, we're going the other way, because there's Kobe Paras on your screens right beside Roscoe. You can see a little bit of frustration in his face, because I'm sure he wants to be in there. And Ayers just continues to look over at Ozawa. Very disappointed with the foul that he got in. Again, instead of just focusing on making the free throw, he looked over at Ozawa and subsequently missed. 13-point lead here enjoyed by Shiga. Looking for more before we end the period. Three on the way! Not going to happen. But still, a very good two quarters put up here by the boys in blue. Shiga is up 36-23 after the first half. Welcome back to the half. Here was the first and only basket of Kobe Parras. Banking that off for that three-pointer. That was the first 3 points of the contest. And the first 3 points, it turned out to be for a while for the visiting squad. And here, Sean O'Mara barrels his way inside. Back-to-back three-point plays, that time from Novar Gadsden. Will give them a 6-3 advantage. Tepe hitting from the outside, swishing that one. And suddenly, we had the boys in blue really in complete control. There's a miss. Ayers with a handoff. Zen Endo gets away. Trying to make up for lost time. He's been out for quite a while. There he is once again. Stepping back, kissing it off the glass. Unfortunately, he would not complete the three-point play. But here, Obisoko going to work against Jeff Ayers. That was his first basket. He'd finish with 10 points. Novar Gadsden kissing that one off the glass. Finally, Nepawe. That's when he can take advantage, when it's Obisoko on him. But when he has Sean O'Mara, he's got such a difficult time trying to get around Sean. Nice hit from the outside there from Nomi. Nomi goes inside. That was the only basket Nepawe had against Sean O'Mara. Sean O'Mara there once again. Active hands. Soko on the break. Forces the issue. Gets at the drop. And he's got a three-point play in the offing once again. He had 2 3-point play opportunities, both of which he converted. Tepe once again with a handoff. Soko with a slam. And the home team enjoyed a big advantage of as big as 17. Right now, it's down to 13. Both these squads not really shooting that well collectively. You can see field goal numbers, 39% for Shiga, 31% for Niigata. But when you break it down from two-point distance, 56% as compared to just 33. That's why they've got the big lead. Looking at the turnovers, 3 turnovers only for Shiga, 15 turnovers for Niigata. 24 and 12, those are the points in the paint. And more interesting numbers are this. Assists, 12 assists as compared to just 4 for Niigata. And in the steals department, 7 steals for Shiga and only 2 steals for Niigata. Individual scoring-wise, let's take a look at the scores. Soko with 10, 9 points there for Sean O'Mara and 7 for Novar Gadsden. For the team that's trailing, 10 points for Tsilidzi Nepawe. 5 points there coming off the bench for Yuto Nomi. And Zen Endo has got 4. These are the other leaders. In the second row, you're going to see 7 rebounds for Obisoko, 8 rebounds there for Jeff Ayers, and Tepe's got 4 assists, while Tsilidzi Nepawe has got 2 assists for his squad. Well, the big question mark is, are we going to see Roscoe Allen on the floor? There he is to the right of your screens, and in the middle of your screens, Kobe Parras, who started out this ball game. He usually is a starter, played for about 3 minutes. He hit a 3, and he has not yet been fielded back in. So questions abound here for Coach Fujitaka Hiraoka. It'll be interesting to see what kind of combinations he sends in the next 2 periods. Well, as far as Shiga's concerned, they're saying, you want to leave them on the bench? It's going to make our job easier. There's Zen Endo. He also played sparingly. He came in, he gave them good minutes, and has not yet been fielded in once again. Let's see what will transpire here. Nice look there at Yuto Nomi. If you're just joining us, we're coming to you from the Ukaruchan Arena, the home of the Shiga Lake Stars. as they host Niigata Albirex. Niigata on an 18-game losing streak. And now there's Kobe Paras starting out, which is a good sign for Niigata. Jeff Ayers going to head on over there to Coach Luis. Coach Luis saying, you know, there was no malice there. We're just trying to play physical. Jeff Ayers picked up a technical foul earlier. And here we go, third period. Once again, Merry Christmas, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for joining us this Saturday afternoon. Christmas Day edition of the B-League. Shiga up against Niigata. We're in the third period. Endo starting out here together with Kobe. That's a good combination. Zen Endo for three. Back rims that one. Gadsden with the rebound. Off. Nice attack. Not going to work there though for Hayashi. Hachide trying to go to Kobe. Kobe's got a mismatch inside, but there's Tsilidzinepawe going to work. I guess Coach Fujitaka said, we're going to go to you despite the fact that you're having a difficult time with O'Mara. Just take it to him. That's exactly what he did there. Maybe if he gets Sean O'Mara out of this ball game or in foul trouble, that opens things up. Three on the way. Tepe going to come up short. O'Mara with the tip. He's going to get the rebound and the putback as he asked for a foul. None given. Still a 13-point lead here, enjoyed by Shiga. They go to Jeff. Double team. And that's off Jeff Ayers. There's Hayashi coming in for the double. That's a good way to send a double from the blind side. And it worked. Gadsden will bring it closer. Stops. Pops. Will miss. Sean O'Mara with a stab from the back. Gadsden inside. Another offensive set. Offensive rebound. And it works there for Gadsden. Two quick rebounds here for Sean O'Mara. Both of them offensive. That's going to be a late whistle. Zen Endo is really forcing the action. Got a little bit of a body there. Slight body check from Gadsden. Gadsden is going to pick up his third personal foul. And let's see what Shiga decides to do. Specifically, Coach Luis Gil Torres. Does he keep Gadsden in there? Because Soko only got one. He's got Soko on the bench. Zen Endo's going to come up short. Another rebound here for Sean O'Mara. He's got three already. Only 2 minutes gone here in period number three. Hayashi will give it back out. Tepe to Gadsden. Hayashi left open. It's a nice tap. We might give him another assist. He's not going to work. Finally, doing some better work on the defensive boards. Here's Kobe. Will Kobe try to be more aggressive? Kobe finds Jeff Ayers. Ayers inside for two. No! How did that not drop? On the break, attacking once again. And it's going to drop here for Shiga. Nice basket there from Nomoto. Lead is back up to 17. And still no Roscoe Allen. Trying to go inside. O'Mara with the steal. Gadsden on the break. He'll wait for the troops. Stops. Puts up a three and hits. And the lead has now ballooned to 20. 12 points in the contest right now here for Novar Gadsden. And a timeout needs to be called by Coach Fujitaka. It's 45-25. Shiga in complete control of this one. 6 minutes, 53 seconds remaining here in the third period. Let's see what offense can be generated off that timeout from Coach Fujitaka. Zen Endo finds Paras. Paras for three. Paras now with 2 3-pointers in the contest, but he has still been played sparingly. Let's see if his minutes increase here in this particular match. Gadsden, they go inside. O'Mara, nice footwork. Baby hook's not going to work. Foul's going to be called on Nomoto. That's going to be the third personal foul on Nomoto. Now might be a good time to bring in Kiefer Ravenna. Kobe. No look pass. Ayers not able to control that one. That's a good lead pass. That clearly came off the foot of Jeff Ayers. Save. Now they're going to run their set. Gadsden to the corner. Open three. A little bit too strong. Nice tap there. And Gadsden delivers another bucket. Boy, Sean O'Mara has really done so much on the offensive boards. A block is going to be called there. A late call. But nonetheless, the right call there on Tepe. He got stopped there by that brick wall. Here comes Kiefer. Usual substitution pattern at about the halfway mark. Kiefer comes in. Zen Endo. Ayers, he'll have to give it up to the top. Almost a steal there, but Paras, a little bit too strong on that one. But you like the aggressiveness he's showing. Here's Ovisoko in the open court. Gets denied there by Tsilidze. Slap of fives. Went up strong. Subsequently got denied. Tsilidze says, not on my watch. Almost at the halfway point of period number three. It's a 19-point lead enjoyed by Shiga. Almost a 5-second violation. They get it inside to Kiefer. Kiefer, two-man game. Steps through, kicks it out. Three on the way. Yes! Assist for Kiefer Ravenna. And a nice three there. It's a 22-point advantage right now. They try to answer back. Ayers does. No, he doesn't. He's going to get it back. And finally, on the third attempt, knocks it through. And very quickly on the other end, Ovisoko. Lead is back up to 22. Now they're going to try to slow things down. Change the tempo. Change the pace. The problem is they're down and they're down big. Nepawe gets away. That was a nice screen run. But unfortunately for Niigata, they're still down by 20. Kiefer, past the timeline. In no hurry. We'll give it up. Kiefer. Nice swing. Good recovery there by Zen Endo. Kiefer was looking to come up with another assist. Nice recovery. blocking Ozawa there. That's a welcome sight here for Niigata to have Zen in the back. Open three, Ozawa hits. He says, okay, I missed on one end, it got blocked. Not this time. 55-32 is our score. 23-point lead now enjoyed by the boys in blue. Ayers gets away. He'll come up short though. He babied that one. Obisoko will get stripped. And scoring there. Tanuki with the basket, but they're going to need a whole lot more of that. And some defensive stops if they want to come back in this ball game. Tepe, poor pass. Not too many turnovers here by Shiga. But they've given up a few here. Ayers inside. Foul's going to be called. Tepe comes in on the blind side. That was well read. Matanuki with a steal. He just hit a basket earlier. Lead pass and a foul is going to be called there on Tepe Kashiwagura. Kashiwagura with three as well. So a lot of players in foul trouble for the boys in blue. But they're happy because they're up by 21. Nice kick out. Ayers can hit it from there. Brings it closer. 16-footer. No. Rebounded there. Ozawa's giving them really good minutes. Early seal. Obisoko gets fouled. Nothing Watanuki can do. Watch it here. Watanuki, remember, only stands at 5'10". Obisoko, on the other hand, is 6'8". That was like taking candy for a baby. Two free throws now coming up for Obisoko. Paras is going to check back in. They need his presence. Obisoko is going to come up short on that first free throw. I'm talking about the presence of Kobe Paras. He can score. He can rebound. And he creates plays for his teammates. Let's see how effective he can be. Two exactly the same misses from Obisoko. Not quite sure that's fatigue. Checking in is Yuto Nomi. That's a poor foul there by Shiga. They've come up with a few poor fouls in the latter stages of the first two periods. And now they've come up with another one here in the latter stage of period number three. Because as Kiefer is mentioning to his teammate, we're in the penalty. And Rion says, yes, my bad. Kiefer pointed up at the scoreboard and said, don't you realize we're giving them easy shots? Nomi makes the first. Nomi makes both. And the lead is down to 19. 2.5 remaining here in the third. O'Mara will give it up. Kiefer. Nice look inside. Soko with a push. Got away with it. But didn't get the shot. We go to the wing. Paras. That's going to be a foul on Obisoko. He just threw Jeff Ayers. That'll be foul number two on Obisoko. Watch it here. Actually, there was a little bit of acting as well from Jeff Ayers. But that's going to be officially the second personal on Ovi. But again, it turns out to be a very poor foul. And Jeff Ayers did the right thing to make sure the referee saw that, because he heads right back to the free throw line An opportunity here for two shots. Nice look there at Coach Fujitaka. His team's down by 19. And it doesn't seem like they're going to be using Roscoe Allen, who actually does practically everything for their squad. Second's going to drop there. Look at the averages once again of Roscoe Allen. He's scoring 19 points, 8 rebounds, and 4 assists. He leads his squad in all departments. Average points, average minutes, average total rebounds, average assists. But he has yet to see action here today. Foul's going to be called there. It's going to be on Zen Endo, his first. We're going to have a first look here at Koya Kawamata. Standing 6'8", 23-year-old. He played for Saga in the B2 last year. He's a project. But he's got height. Excellent look inside, but blowing the cripple there was Rion. Kiefer was saying that was an assist. No basket there for Shiga. The lead has been cut down here by Niigata. Back to Ayers. Jeff Ayers. Will he force the issue? Yes, he does, and scores. Jeff Ayers coming alive here in the second half. Only had 2 points in the first two periods of play. Paras trying to stay there with Kiefer. Obisoko attacks, finds the big man, and the big man Koya scores. He says, yes, I'm a project, but I know what to do when I'm inside and deep. And don't look now, but he got fouled. And the foul is going to be called on Jeff Ayers. So Ayers is going to pick up another personal. That's going to be number 3. And Koya makes the free throw. That gives him a more comfortable 18-point lead. Exactly a minute remaining in the third period. Back to Jeff Ayers. Zen Endo gets toppled, and another free throw coming up here. Ozawa really makes sure those fouls of his count. That's going to be his third. And again, two free throws coming up here for Niigata. This time for Zen Endo. It's going to rattle out. He's going to miss the second as well. Obisoko's going to pick this one up. Kiefer now calling out the play. Kiefer for 3. A little bit too strong. The tap. And it's going to stay with Shiga once again. Ovi now decides to attack. Left-handed shot not going to work. Koya gets denied. But once again, the boys in blue quicker to the basketball. They throw that one up. That's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. So now shot clock is off. 22.6 seconds remaining in the game clock here in the third period. Coach Luis asking, saying, that was an attempt. They should have reset the shot clock. Nonetheless, that's the situation. 18-point lead enjoyed by Shiga. And he got the score here. Zen. Nice handoff. Koya comes up with a foul. That's going to be his first. That's very good strategy. because even the international imports are having a hard time stopping Nepau. Well, now that you've got Koya inside, why not attack him? Two free throws now coming up. Nepau is going to make these free throws, though. He only died downside, but there he is. There's that miss. I was about to say the only downside by attacking early is the fact that you're giving Shiga 6.7 seconds for their offensive pattern. Kobe Paras has been relieved once again. Nepawe misses both. Here's Soko. He will attack for sure. Does. Hands it off to Koya. Koya scores. Let's double check if there's a foul. There was some contact. But they say no contact. But 2 points nonetheless for the big man. Koya running the break. And Kawamata now has 5 points in the contest. Stick around for the fourth and final period coming right after this. Merry Christmas and welcome back to the Ukarochan Arena, the home of the Shiga Lake Stars, as they look to deal Niigata Albirex their 19th straight loss. Obisoko there with a turnover. Ozawa was saying he was coming up towards the ball and the pass was given to the corner. Miscommunication that time results in a turnover for Shiga. Niigata still trailing by 20 here. But there's a lot of time remaining, but they need to make their move now. They got to make their move, unfortunately, for them, without Jeff Ayers to start out the fourth period. They're not using Roscoe Allen today, and they've used Kobe Paras sparingly. Foul's going to be called there on Tepe. That's going to be the fourth personal foul on Tepe Kashibugura. The only problem here so far for Shiga today is a lot of their key players are in foul trouble. But they've got a 20-point cushion. Some changes going to be made here by Coach Luis Gil Torres. Doesn't want to sacrifice Tepe yet as he sends in Nomoto. Nomoto, though, has got three personals as well. So not exactly in the best situation. Get it inside. Watanuki. From the outside. Three's not going to work. That might stay here. Last touch on Sean O'Mara. Open there was Tomoki Hoshino. And he missed everything. Sean O'Mara saying, I was pushed from the back, but nonetheless, that ball did come off him last. And a foul is going to be called. That's going to be on Kiefer. That's going to be Kiefer's second personal foul. They're calling it really close. There's Kiefer there with a little bit of a hold. Actually, he held him twice. Nepal is going to lose it. It falls in the hands of O'Mara. Ovi Soko with a slam. And the lead is now at 22. Not the kind of way you want to run your offense, especially when you're down 20. And now you're down 22. Nepawe will try to challenge. Will overshoot. Nepawe against the triple team gives it up. Hurried three. Not going to drop. Nice rebound there. And things are going from bad to worse here. As we saw Nomi step on the sideline. Good offensive rebound though, coming from Tomoki. Coach Fujitaka can only wonder, what could I do with a full complement of players? That's good hustle defensively there. That's going to force a turnover in Kiefer. That's a turnover that Shiga can afford. Kiefer knew it. Nomi will be replaced, and he gets an earful there from Coach Fujitaka Hiraoka. Chance of defense. The pass went over to Nepawe, and Nepawe wasn't even waiting for it, and he just ran over Kiefer. Nepawe with his second personal. Seems like they're trying to go to Nepawe. He wasn't expecting it. He just went straight into Kiefer Ravenna. Knocked him down and picked up his second personal. Not a very good start to this fourth period, actually, for both these teams. Jeff Ayers back in action. You can't keep him on the bench if you don't want to use Kobe, if you don't want to use Roscoe. You need as many reinforcements as you can against a team that is using three reinforcements. They got Ravenna, Soko, and O'Mara. There, Soko. Nice show. Easy layup. And the lead is now at 24, at 64-40. That foul might be on Ovi Soko. And that'll be his third. Let's get confirmation. Definitely on Soko. And here comes Novar Gansen. He also has three, but he's fresh off the bench. Open three, not gonna drop there. Another offensive rebound here for Tomoki. He's helped them out, getting extra possessions. The problem is, they've still not scored. Step back three. Finally, he's going to drop there for Zen Endo. Still a 21-point disadvantage for Niigata. Kiefer gives it over to Novar. Back to Kiefer. Kiefer will attack. And he'll be fouled. It was actually an open three that he found. Turns out to be a good foul here for Niigata. They might have saved themselves 3 points. That's going to be the fourth personal foul on the starter, Watanuki. Open three. That answers the three. And the lead is back up to 24. Just when it looked like there was some momentum going the way of the boys in white, Nomoto says, "We want this victory, and we want it badly." Fourth period is underway, 7:30 to be exact, remaining in this contest. Bobby Paras has been reinserted in the lineup. Time for one final push for Niigata to try to avert the fact that they're going to lose. They could lose their 19th straight game here. Can it finally happen on Christmas Day? Novar Gadsden and company says, "Nope, we want to get the victory ourselves." Novar Gadsden with a turnover there. But time is running out on the boys in white. Down by 24. Mathematically still possible. But with the way Niigata has been scoring and the way Niigata has played all throughout the afternoon, it's not likely. And then you give up a poor pass. Boy, what was Kobe thinking that time? Sean O'Mara was right there. Watch it here. Sean O'Mara was just waiting for him to issue out that pass. Foul's going to be called on Paras. And they're going to review this one to see if it's an unsportsmanlike foul. I don't think so. Watch it here. Well, Kobe looked like he was trying to go for the ball. But of course, my opinion doesn't matter. It's the referee's opinion that holds all the weight. And two of our three officials are there checking out the situation. Once again, a good job done here by our three referees. Referee Okawara, Referee Kubo, and Referee Iwatsuki. Just a regular foul, as we expected. Kobe Paras, though, will be replaced, and by the looks of things, he might not be back on the floor, and you can see just how disappointed he is. You just got sent in. You were looking to do something positive for your squad, and you come up with a loose pass such as that one. A little bit of contact there from Ozawa. Ayers was looking for a three-point play, but a foul would be called there on Sean O'Mara. That'll be foul number two. And that's going to put Shiga in the penalty. Clash of wrists there with Ozawa. And Sean O'Mara looked like he was actually giving that shot. Because at this stage, he just wants to stay out of foul trouble. They want the clock to be running. The clock, at least today, is their friend. Ozawa gets replaced. Training staff are going to look at him. Wasn't exactly actually the wrist. It was more on the back of the hand, and he's in obvious pain. Hoping there's no ligament damage there. But Ayers can't get that to drop. Look at the free throws. They're shooting below 50%. They're shooting 7 out of 17. Now make that 8 out of 18. Still well below 50%, and they're shooting Wolves from the 15-foot line. Will not help them back in this ball game. They can't correct that. Nomoto quickly out to O'Mara. Gadsden, all by his lonesome, will get away. A little bit of contact. Officials say let it go. Here's Ayers running the break. And a foul is going to be called on Novar Gadsden. Gadsden, that'll be number 4 on him. And with his team in the penalty foul situation, it's 2 more free throws for Jeff. The question is, can they make their free throws to get back in this one? Coach Hiraoka was actually a longtime Albirex player, issuing out some last-minute instructions to his squad. He feels it's still possible. Yes, mathematically it is. Can they do it? That is the biggest question of the day. 67-45 is our tally. One more free throw coming up here for Jeff Ayers. You can see Roscoe Allen at the end of the bench. And a lot of fans have come over here for Niigata. 10 points already now for Jeff Ayers. Gadsden stutter step. Gets at the drop. That was just too easy for Novar. And Novar is saying, I'm going to try to score before I get replaced because I've got 4 personal fouls. Before I hit the bench permanently here tonight, I want to be able to give my team a much better advantage. Nepawe will misfire. Ayers with the offensive rebound. Extra pass. 3 works. Nice basket there from Ikeda. Can they spark some sort of a rally? Maybe one of the smartest point guards here in Kiefer Ravenna for Shiga. That's going to be difficult. Kiefer. Just when I said that, he issues a pass a little bit out of the radar of his 3-point shooter. Still a 20-point lead enjoyed by Shiga. Time running out though. Onigata. 5:27 to be played here this Christmas Day. Once again, we'd like to say Merry Christmas. Thank you for joining us. Anthony Suntay with the call as we have Shiga hosting Niigata at the Ukaruchan Arena. Nepawe. Power dribble. Goes to the left hand, lays it through, and the lead is down to 18. And a foul is going to be called here. And that foul will send Niigata into the penalty as well. And that might be the final foul of Watanuki. He's done. Watanuki is now fouled out. Past the halfway mark of the fourth and final period. Kiefer. Nice look. A little bit too strong there from Hayashi. Zen Endo. Quick hands from Kiefer. It's a 3-on-1 break. Will they force the issue? Kiefer gets blocked. Zen Endo, making up for his earlier miscue, comes up with a block there. It's going to lead us to a technical timeout. Stick around. Some more basketball action to be played when we return. The turnovers continue to mount here for Niigata. They've got 23 as compared to just 11 for Shiga. 4:39 remaining in this one. Looking to make it an official victory here. O'Mara on the outside against Jeff Ayers. We'll bring it closer. We'll miss Nepawi with the rebound. We got the stop. Talking about Niigata. Can they get the bucket? On the outside, Ayers inside. Nepawi carves out some space. We'll miss. Can't get the tip. Nomoto clears. And now over to Gadsden. And they're going to use some clock. Gadsden for the dagger. Knocks down that three. And the lead back up to 21. Endo gets blocked. And that just could be it. Especially if Gadsden scores here. Nomoto misses. Pepe Kashibagura has been reinserted here. There's Nomoto. Back rims that one, and the ball is going to stay here on this end. He apologizes. Got a good shot, though. 3:31 remaining. Sean O'Mara is going to hit the bench, and that could be it. As they send in Koya Kawamata. He had 5 points. And this 23-year-old who we talked about earlier, doing well for his squad. That's going to be a travel. Yuichi Ikeda had control, traveled before he issued a pass. If they scored there, maybe the door might have been slightly ajar for a comeback. But now you're going to see Shiga use clock once again. We got a three-guard setup. Kiefer. Falling away. That rattles out. Used up a lot of clock that time. That was actually priority number one. And Jeff Ayers might be called for an offensive foul here. Ayers will pick up another personal, and that should do it for this ball game. Only 4 personal fouls. But he'll be replaced, and it doesn't seem like... Well, now they're going to send Kobe Parasin in place of Jeff Ayers. No, Kobe Parasin is coming in for someone else. Nonetheless, Jeff Ayers is out of this ball game. They've replaced Nepawi as well. The coach Fujitaka calling on the clean crew. Except for Kobe Barras, of course. But this is time for Kobe to get a little bit more minutes. Foul's going to be called. Both teams in the penalty. That's a poor foul. Under 3 minutes to play in this one. Clearly a foul there on Yuto Nomi. That's his first. Kiefer Avena will be replaced. Trying to preserve the minutes of the Phenom. It's a one ball game here. And unfortunately for Niigata and their fans, their team will go down to their 19th straight loss. And they're going to drop to 2 wins against 20 defeats. On the other hand, Shiga will get back into the winning column and pick up their 8th victory here this season. 74-51 is our tally. For no more fouls to be called here. Getting away inside and scoring is Keigo Kimura. Kimura actually started out this ball game. Almost a turnover. It is. One of the few turnovers here in the second period. Second half, rather. That's only turnover number 12 for Shiga. Niigata has 25 already. Still chance of defense from the fans here at the Okaru-chan Arena. They want their victory to be a slam-bang affair. That's going to be a foul on Nomoto. That's going to be number 4. He says, I took it right on the chest. But he put his hand down as well, trying to swipe. Pretty good game nonetheless for Daichi Nomoto. As of a miss here from Keigo. Keigo makes a second. We're going to be approaching the last 2 minutes of a game that's outcome has already been settled. Leon checks in. A lot of pressure being put, and they safely get it past the timeline. Again, going to use clock. Rion with a handoff. Shibuya back to Rion. Rion for three. No. That's going over to Niigata. Still a 20-point lead enjoyed here by Shiga as they look to coast here in the final 2 minutes. Final 2 minutes here, so we have an anticlimactic. Here we go. Shiga is going to make their fans really happy, though, because they're back on the winning track. Picked up their 8th victory. Nice rebound there by Koya. They're going inside to their big man. He's going to be fouled, and two more free throws coming up here for Koya Kawamata. Second personal foul there going to be called on Nomi. Koya actually has 5 points already here. He's got 6. He's got a very good touch from that free throw line. Kawamata has only played 3 minutes and 5 seconds. But he's got 7 points. Very productive night here for the youngsters. And they're expecting big things from the 6'8 beanpole. He's going to come up with a foul there, though. A little bit late to react on that incursion from Oya. Kotaro Oya will head to the line for 2 shots. A minute, 25 seconds remaining in this one. There's a stat line on Kotaro Oya as he makes both free throws. We have Tomoki Hoshino checking in. He saw action briefly in the first half. Traveling is going to be called here. Well, the turnovers are now piling up for Shiga here in the latter stage of period number 4. Essentially a 1-ball game. Still a 20-point lead is what they're protecting. And again, chance of defense. You gotta love the fans. They want a resounding victory. Jumper is gonna be in and out. Koya taps it to himself. Almost traveled there. Nope, he got caught. He traveled. That was clear. A minute, 6 seconds remaining. Watch it here. That's a good tap. He controlled the ball. That was more than a hop, skip, and a drop. Can't make that turn. Koya was there. They kick it out. Turnover there. Coming from Kotaro Oya. 57 seconds remaining in this one. You can see the frustrated look on Jeff Ayers. Seated almost right beside Coach Fujitaka Hiraoka. Lead Vance. Hayashi controls. Rion says, let's let the clock expire. Well, trying to put up a three there to join the scoring. Quick three is going to drop. Nice basket. But unfortunately, they're still down by 17. Nomoto's going to get fouled. I'm not sure if Oshino realizes, but this game is out of reach. 32.5 seconds remaining. 17-point lead. They foul, and they're going to give the boys in blue two more free throws. This time it is hotshot Daichi Nomoto. Nomoto playing on four personal fouls. Wanted to add to his tally and does. Nomoto now with 6 points to go with two rebounds. He's in there for defense more than anything else, though. But he can hit that outside shot. Not to mention, he can make the free throws. He is back up to 19. Are we going to see more fouls? Are we going to see more free throws? Nope, we're going to see a turnover. And now the shot clock is off. 22 seconds remaining in this one. I can't see Shiga taking a shot. But there's a turnover. Nomoto smiling, he can't believe it. No smiles there from Jack, gentlemen. Coach Hiraoka, very displeased. 19 straight losses for his squad. It's back to the drawing board and more. Step back three, in and out there. That would have been a nice basket for Kimura. And they're not even going to get it past the timeline. It's a one ball game here for Shiga as they improve to 8 wins against 14 defeats. That's your final score, 78-59. Niigata, courtesy of Kobe Paras. Got the first basket of this ball game off a three. And after that, Shiga never looked back. A lot of things to discuss here for Coach Fujitaka and his staff. They're going to need a quick turnaround because these two teams face each other once again tomorrow. And if they're not going to use Roscoe Allen and they're going to use Kobe Paras sparingly, they're in for another long afternoon. Nice victory there for Kiefer Ravenna, Luis Gil Torres, and the rest of the Shiga Lake Stars. There's Kobe saying, I'll see you tomorrow. Kobe would finish with 6 points today off two threes. He had one in the first period and one in the second half. And now we're going to hear from our winning coach, Luis Gil Torres, and some of the stars of the win here for the Shiga Lake Stars. Again, if you're just joining us here for B-League action, that's almost always what happens. Yes, we have
Merry Christmas.
The whole team talking to the fans. Some a little bit longer than usual, but here, let's listen to Coach Luis. Man of a few words, that's what I'm telling you about. That's why a lot of times we have coaches a little bit more diverse in how they break down their matches. Who do you hear from here? And the mascot's going to come in here.
They're steppy.
Well, there, you could understand that definitely. From Pepe Kashiwagura saying that they wanted to make sure that they gave their fans a huge Christmas gift, and that's exactly what they were able to do. And now it would be nice to be able to listen to the behemoth, Koya Kawamata. Again, you understood that one, even if you don't understand Japanese. Well, always thank the fans for coming over, and he said this was a Christmas present to all the fans. Not just those that have come over to the Okarachan Arena, but to all the fans of the Shiga Lake Stars. Now we have Nomoto. Nomoto had 7 points here today. Another good contribution. Once again, for the fans in the Philippines, you can catch all the B-League action on Tap Sports. Tap Go, the smart GigaPlay app, and the Facebook page and YouTube channel of Puso Pilipinas. Once again, Merry Christmas, and thank you very much for joining us here this Saturday afternoon as you witnessed Shiga picking up another victory, victory number 8.
Number 23, Novar Gadson.
And they're going to call in Novar Gadson. And he's taking off his shooting shirt. And he's going to receive his MVP check. Great contribution by Novar here today. Actually, it is a total team effort. Defensively, they really shut down their opponents. Look at the scoring. Niigata only scored 11 and 12 in the first two periods. And then 17 in the third. And their biggest period was in the fourth with 19 points, when actually the outcome was already settled. And sometimes we have some of the young fans coming in. Sometimes they ask a question. And here, just a picture with Novar Gadson. Might be a future star of the B-League. Who knows?
ありがとうございました。
A lot of fans have made their way. And now let's hear from Novar.
Konnichiwa. Thank you guys for coming out, supporting us on a holiday. It's tough for a couple of us guys, but we wouldn't want to be nowhere else. We're trying to continue to get better as a group. Every day we want to continue to progress, and thank you.
はい、クリスマスというホリデーの中、たくさんの方が会場に足を運んでいただきありがとうございます。今日しっかり勝つことはすごい良かったですし、これからももっともっと成長しながら、家庭の部分にフォーカスしながら戦っていきたいと思います。ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございました。さて、滋賀レッグスターズはいよいよ明日ここオカルチャンアリーナで行われます新潟アルフレックス BB との第2戦が年内最後のホームゲームとなります。引き続き会場にお越しいただきブースターの皆さん、
Stick around in just a bit. We're going to be showing you the highlights of the four quarters of play that happened here this Christmas day, as Coach Luis Gil Torres says thank you to the fans once again, and he will get right back to work because they will face this very same Niigata Albirex squad in less than 24 hours. Before we call it a day here on our Beely coverage, we'll show you the highlights, we'll run the numbers through you, and show you the best performers from both squads. Good performance there from Koya Kawamata, number 99. Kiefer Avena very happy. He's away from his family for the very first time. But he's going to take away a victory for himself and for the Shiga Lake Stars. First attempt here for Kobe Baras, kissing that off the glass. We'll finish with 2 3-pointers. Jeff Ayers with a poor pass, one of the too many turnovers for Niigata. They had 27 in total. Sean O'Mara with the basket there. Gadsden completes a three-point play there as well. That gave them a six-point lead, and from that point on, they never looked back. Tepe hits from three. Good defense that time. And Zen Endo coming off the bench gave them so much energy. Kissing that off the glass, he would miss the free throw though. And then Obi Soko going to work. One of the few games he's come off the bench, but he's a special individual. Whether he's a starter, whether he comes off the bench, he just continues to produce, just like what you saw Novar Gadsden also a while ago. Nepawe with a drop step, works with a slam. Nice bucket there, coming from Nomi. Sean O'Mara had the number of Nepawe, except for that one particular instance. Look at the effort shown here. On the defensive end, basket on one opportunity. And that's one of the five fouls of Shun Watanuki. That's why he fouled out. Easy slam there from Obi Soko. First period ended in favor of Shiga, 21-11. Second period ended still in favor of Shiga, 36-23. They would change ends, and it was more of the same. In fact, a more, can we say, impressive third period for the boys in blue. They got just too many offensive rebounds here in the third period. They converted on a lot of their second chance opportunities. And as they say, the rout was on. Obisoko there with another slam. The third period would end with their squad up by 20. They led 60-40. Ozawa joining in the scoring act. He was there primarily for defense. Nice basket there from Watanuki. Right before he fouled out. The big man, Koya. He'd score a three-point play. He'd make the free throw. And he'd score here off the break. That brought the entire bench off their seats. And here another slam from Obisoko. Maybe you're going to see him coming off the bench a little bit more. But he's just as effective as a starter. Step back three there for Zen Endo. But answering right back was Nomoto. Coming off the bench, Yuichi Ikeda would hit a three. But it was obviously not enough. Because Novar Gadsen and the rest of his crew were on target here this afternoon. Some points in garbage time. And your final score in this one, 78-59. A victory for Shiga as they move to 8-14.